Halloween. Yeah. And when it comes to Halloween, really, you can't get anyone bigger as a guest.
No, Mistress of the Dark, baby.
You know what I'm saying?
I heard that.
Huh. Elvira just walked in to the Free FM studios. She's at the end of the hallway, so I'm going to let her walk on through.
Right.
You think she still does the cleavage deal?
I'm hoping.
Me too.
If not, she's out of here.
No.
I'm kidding. I love her.
She can judge our little competition as well. Instead of the listeners doing it, she can judge it.
Okay.
Do this thing once in a while where we each find an article. They're not hard to find.
Oh.
Of some just disgusting, despicable human being on this planet that should be taken behind the shed and shot in the head.
Sick bastard.
We'll all throw in a nomination and then she'll select the person to be shot in the head.
Sweet. Welcome! How are you?
Hi.
Phenomenal now that you're here. How are you?
Good.
Good, good.
Nope,
good.
We don't get the thing that you were.
I know.
Yeah,
it is.
It is.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, been a little updated.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But why did you go, did you have a bad experience with him?
No, I had a good experience with Howard.
Oh, okay.
But it was just tense. It was.
Oh, really?
What's it going to do to me? What's going to happen?
Yeah,
right.
I was just sweating it. I drank like a water glass full of Jack Daniels.
Oh, good.
Did you really?
Did you bring any today?
No, I didn't have to, I hope.
You look lovely as a redhead. Is that your natural color?
Yeah.
That is gorgeous. I had no idea.
Now, will people be expecting, though, to see the dark hair?
They're going to.
Okay. Oh, they are.
They're going to.
And the cleavage.
I just don't do it this early in the morning.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you do the cleavage this early?
Oh, yeah. No,
you do?
Well, no.
No, not.
Okay.
Right. Husband, yeah.
Whoa!
Oh.
Okay. Mamacita.
Oh.
Howdy doody.
Boo.
Boobs. So, yeah. Boobs.
Anyway, watch it, buddy.
Boobs.
Welcome. So, you come to New York a lot?
I do. Fairly often.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Right on.
How about the same question without New York in the sentence?
Oh, come on.
Well, I'm just asking.
He's just,
it's just a question.
Right.
You know?
Good God.
As often as possible.
Okay.
Oh, good.
Married lady?
I'm in the middle of a divorce.
Oh, me too.
Him too.
Right. Let's go
tonight.
Let's go, baby.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Jack Daniels night?
Right.
Yeah.
Let's go. Me and Elvira. Yeah.
Now, he's on the losing side. Are you on the winning or the losing side of this?
She's the deal.
Unfortunately, on the losing side.
Really?
Yeah, you know.
Oh, because you made all the money, and this leech is going to take it all, or half of it.
Right, because you've got the cash. How long were you married?
Because I live in California.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, me too. All right,
25 years.
25 years?
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And let me guess, it went wrong. It went south about 15 years into it.
Yes.
And then you just stick it out for
what
another
is that?
10 years.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right. How'd you know that?
I just know.
Right.
I know.
Because he's getting
watched my partner.
He gets married in December, so he'll know.
Yeah.
Right. Don't tell him not to.
Oh, yeah, that's what happened. And then you just suffer along for the
right. Really?
Yeah.
I mean, that's... Lou over here tells me that it's all
how long have you been married, Lou?
A walk in the park?
A year and a half. Give it time, pal.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I tell people I had 10 wonderful years of marriage. Unfortunately, I was married 25.
Yeah. Jesus. So you married Frankenstein, right?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Actually, the werewolf.
Oh.
Actually, a vampire because he's sucking me dry.
Yeah. I'd love to. Thanks for the offer.
Thank you. Oh, no. You're welcome.
Anyway, back to reality.
So, where did the whole Elvira thing come from and how did it start? Because it's legend now.
Right.
Your legend with Halloween.
Yes. Thank you. Mm-hmm. It started in L.A. I started hosting local horror movies there,
right.
Which,
okay.
By the way, are out on DVD.
Okay.
Pump it.
This month,
okay.
My original movie, Macabre Show, you can get it at Elvira.com.
Okay.
So
cool.
The original shows, but I started at the Groundling Theater. I was in improv there.
Okay.
With Phil Hartman and Paul Rubens and all those people.
Wow.
And heard about a local horror host gig. They were looking for a horror host. So
hey, you dumb whore. Yeah.
Horror.
Yeah.
Horror.
My bad.
Horror.
You have a choice there. It's a horror or whatever else you want to do.
Yeah, right. Horror movie.
Or
yes,
host.
Right.
It's like trick or treat.
Horror or host. Right. There you go. Yeah.
So I took the host.
Okay.
I took the hosting job.
Mm-hmm.
And ended up, it was a local show. I really thought they were just going to do a pilot. I thought it'd last, one day. I mean, it was so stupid.
I know. Right.
And then,
you don't say I know.
Years.
No. I'm just agreeing with her.
I was doing.
She's a hot woman. What am I supposed to say? Come on. Jesus.
I mean, the movies were really, really bad. I had no idea what I was doing. I was doing this character that was sort of this Valley Girl character that they liked at the Groundlings. And and then they said, come up with a spooky look. And I'm like, but it doesn't go with the Valley Girl thing. And they go, it doesn't matter.
Go for it. Right.
And they like the cleavage and the, you know.
Well, who doesn't? Mm-hmm. Except Rudy in the corner. He's gay and he's got his own cleavage.
Yeah. I bet he's in love with her, too.
Isn't this, he says he's bisexual.
Say it and it's true.
Elvira, or your real name is Cassandra Peterson. When did you start taking off the ring?
When did I start?
Yeah, because I know you're not wearing one. You're coming on to me, is what I'm saying.
I took it off a long time ago.
Oh, you did?
I got allergic to it. It was so bizarre. Right. About 5 years ago.
Mm-hmm. It was a sign.
Started causing an allergy, and I had to quit wearing it. Isn't that weird?
Well, yeah, that's what those red and cubic zirconias will do to you.
You know what? My C-ring is doing the same thing.
I have got a swollen
grapefruit.
I'll help you with that at one.
Okay, thanks,
buddy. Or Pendulette will.
I appreciate that.
You can do magic.
Yeah, magic.
With my,
you know, Pendulette is, right?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
He's coming in. He's doing a live broadcast. Uh-oh. Rudy's his producer today.
Really? Yeah,
so just a little bit of information.
He's the talking one.
So let's talk about your gig. You're in town for the big parade, and are you doing any signings? Can people meet you?
No.
Wow. I like that.
Right.
Yeah.
It's in my contract. No one can meet me.
Uh-huh. No, I've actually been doing a lot of that recently. I'm doing NASCAR. I was supposed to do
it. I didn't know you drive a NASCAR.
I didn't either. Elvira. Wow.
Yeah, no.
And you had a spare tire? That's awesome.
No, she didn't.
You won in NASCAR with a spare tire.
I did.
That is amazing.
That's jacked up.
About me. But it was good.
Thank you.
So,
let me check your oil.
I was signing autographs there, but I'm not here because I wanted to float, and I'm just sort of floating along, and we don't want people to crawl up on the float and die.
Right.
Get caught under the wheels.
And I think it's going to be nice. It's going to be like, no, it's not.
What? No, but the weather's nice.
Oh, the weather.
Yeah, it's going to be nice. It's like 70 today.
Oh, it's going to be nice out.
What's wrong with the parade?
Oh, it's the worst.
Stop.
Look at you. You're a web goon back there.
Hey, Joe.
Looking at porn.
Let me teach you something about radio.
Yeah.
I'll have to stand up and give me 1 second.
A little respect here.
She's a guest.
Right. And a great guest, a very famous guest.
She's here to promote a gig that she's doing and that she's trying to create excitement about.
There's plenty
of reason for there to be excitement. And she's asking everyone to come out. And then the web guy walks in and goes, that sucks.
Right. I'm looking forward to it.
You should be fired for that.
And I know I shouldn't open my mouth.
He's just jealous because he's not in it.
You know what? Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah. He's just a goon.
I don't care if the parade's good or not.
I
don't care that they see me.
Yeah. Now, you're on a specific float, right?
I am. It's called, it's odd, but it's called mypetscene.com.
Okay.
And I'm on their float because I'm an animal lover, as you know.
Oh,
and
I killed a bag of puppies this morning.
Oh, God.
Is that wrong? I'm kidding.
No, that's
I
not
love
wrong.
Dogs. Okay. When they're on the
yes.
Oh, okay. My day.
MyPetScene.com. MyPetScene.com.
That's the main thing. So MyPetScene.com. Didn't you have a regular thing?
Pet owners. It's like dating for pet owners. It really
Oh, really? So a dog can just get on the computer and wait, what's up, dog?
All right.
Hey, trying to find some bitches.
What's up, cool cat? Love it.
Yeah. No, I think it works for people too.
Are you in heat?
They have a dog and they met like at the dog park or something.
Right.
You can get online and you can find them.
Do you think these dogs, they go on the computer and their computer, they're just like humans after a little meth? All they want to do is just hump.
Right.
I think so.
Okay.
Just see their ribs, tail in the air.
date.
Now, you didn't have Elvira. A little roof and all. Roof and all.
Roof and all.
Whatever you want to do, I'm fine with that. You did a movie, too, right? An Elvira movie?
I've done a few of them. I did
Elvira,
Mistress of the Dark.
No, she talked about her TV show. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, I have that, too, a reality show.
Please help me out, Elvira. Didn't you mention your movie?
No, I didn't.
Thank you. Get off my back. Thanks. What's up, baby?
Elvira's Haunted Hills, that's my other one.
Okay.
Right on.
And I did an IMAX movie. You can't buy that one, though. You have to have a really big screen for that one.
Okay. Are your boobs in 3D?
Yes, they are.
Oh my God.
And they're like 40 feet high.
Yes!
Wow.
It's like one of those travel log things of the Grand Canyon.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And everything.
Love that.
But, Haunted Hills was my last movie, and now I have a reality show coming out.
Really?
You do?
Yeah, from the people that did American Idol, Fremantle.
Okay.
And so that'll be out.
What's the concept?
Is I go around the United States looking for other Elvira?
That's plural.
Elvira, yeah.
Not Elviruses?
Viruses. Right.
Mm-hmm. The viruses are spreading.
They are.
Mm-hmm.
We hope not.
No, yeah.
So we find,
maybe the knees. I don't know.
Right.
Yeah. So we find other Elviras that go out and kind of do my, my evil bidding.
Right.
Because it's sort of like cloning myself.
Oh, okay.
So I have other Elviras that go there, like all the cheap jobs that I can't do.
All
So I find other Elviras, and then we whittle it down by a series of tests to one Elvira.
Okay. Gotcha.
Are you in costume the whole time?
I am. Mm-hmm. I'm Elvira the whole time.
The whole time.
That'll be next Halloween.
How was it wearing that wig the whole time?
It is pretty hot and sweaty and scratchy.
I wish she was in the full getup. I mean,
that's
I was really looking forward to that.
I'm glad she's
not. And I still appreciate this.
I had no idea she was this attractive outside of the getup.
I knew.
Honestly.
Oh,
you did?
Yeah.
Seen her? I didn't know that.
No, I didn't see her, but I just some things you just know.
I know, but you wear that thick black
like
makeup.
Like you just don't know when to shut up.
No, well, what
take
I was saying was, okay.
No, it's like Howard Stern. He said that was old, but he still liked to screw me.
Yeah.
I thought that was a good one.
Hey, put me on that list. The GOAT, what's up?
Can I get a crank water, please?
Please get this guy a crank water. Elvira, you want a crank water?
Oh, yeah, please.
Yeah. Okay.
Starbucks crank water.
Coming right up.
So, what's happening, buddy?
Goat.
Yo, all right, hear that. Great show, guys.
Thank
Elvira,
you, sir.
Elvira, you, I must say, for many years, growing up and watching as a kid some of the shows that, you've been in, you are an extremely beautiful woman.
Ooh, thank you. Oh, you're one of those guys who I helped through puberty, right?
Yes.
I mean, a lot of them.
A lot of wash rags.
I want to be polite as I possibly can.
Thank you.
Why start now?
Mm-hmm. You're right, but like I said, I wanted to say you are an extremely beautiful woman.
Mm-hmm. Well,
what a nice call.
Yeah, thanks, Goat.
Thank you. That's nice.
We, every year, see you on television. Do you get paid big money? Like I think you've done stuff with beer and
chips
and
sure
whatever.
Yeah.
I mean, is it a bidding war when it comes Halloween time?
It's pretty. We pretty much start in November, looking at different jobs. Mm-hmm. Mostly, I make my money in licensing and merchandising.
Okay.
Okay.
But guess what? Your husband's getting half of that.
Yeah.
Oh. You had a reminder.
Damn it! I'm sorry. We'll go. We'll have a Jack Daniels later.
Oh,
okay.
God,
cool.
Yeah.
We're talking about dead puppies. Cool.
Yeah.
At mypetscene.com. Yes.
There's no dead puppies at that webpage.
Oh,
what
God.
Is it again?
No. Mypetscene, SCENE.com.
And again, it's a place for
pet owners.
Yeah.
Also ask advice about like pet herpes or whatever, anything that might be
what?
Wrong
what?
Well, after you got your pet together. No, you go on there. Oh,
they don't have herpes.
Well, they might. They might get it, but like different things that pets get, diseases and stuff.
But
and
you think
talk about it, and there's vet advice and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
So you have
were you just throwing that out, or were you guessing that pets get?
I was guessing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, gotcha.
Because my dog, I mean, I'm not going to let him go out without a condom in his wallet.
Exactly. And it's a female. Love it. Jessica, what's up?
Hi. I just wanted to tell Elvira that my fiancé is the biggest fan.
Ooh, thank you.
He actually just had the whole top half of his arm tattooed of you.
Wow. For life.
I get a lot of those.
Do you really?
That's a good fan, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Oh,
totally.
I sign hundreds of Elvira tattoos on various parts of the body.
What's on your webpage, Elvira.com?
Elvira.com. It's got a little bit of everything. It's got what I'm up to, what I'm going to be doing,
photos?
My licensing, merchandise. No negative photos.
Oh, damn it.
It's got just fun advice and things about Halloween and lots of stuff. It's fun.
Did Hefner ever approach you about doing
it? Oh, yeah, he did.
Yeah.
I keep telling people I just shot the girl next door. But what I meant is I just shot the show, the girl next door.
Right.
I didn't actually shoot her.
Oh, yeah.
So I just saw Hef like a week ago and, he calls me the one who got away.
Really?
He offered me lots of money. It was up to the highest offer that they had made. And
really?
I had to turn it down. I took a vote of my fans. It wasn't that I'm shy because I think a lot of people know I'm not shy.
Yeah, right.
But,
you let your fans decide on the biggest offer Hef has ever thrown out?
Yeah. Oh, no.
Because
stupid
they
move.
Just thought that I should keep the mystery of the character and not sort of
what fan is telling you keep the mystery?
All of them.
But
I couldn't decide. I wanted
them. I'm going to nominate them.
Really bad.
You know, Elvira, we do this segment once in a while where we throw out someone who's in the news who's done just something heinous. Something worse. We nominate someone who's done something heinous in this world, and then the listeners decide who should be shot in the head. I think I'm just going to nominate all her fans who decided we don't want to see you naked.
Thanks for nothing, goons.
No, I need my fans. I need my fans.
So do they, on your webpage, do they pay? Or is there a membership?
Okay. You just go on. No,
you just go on and just have a good time.
Sweet.
So nice.
You order merchandise, like my new DVDs.
DVDs,
my movie Macabre DVDs.
Right.
And then this stuff, or my costume, which comes in large size, in case you're interested.
Oh, what are you trying to say?
Plus size.
Oh, okay.
Plus size for him. Right.
Oh, right. Hey! Yeah. God, it's
you'll have to increase
eating.
The breasts for him, though.
Stress eating. I'm going through a divorce. I think you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
You weren't going through a divorce 4 years ago.
Oh, well, that's, come on, I have another
or 10 or
that. All right, drop it, dummy.
Stupid question, but do you then... After Halloween time, do you kind of relax and just bathe in all the money you made?
Yeah, good
no,
Lord,
I don't
woman.
Really get to. Everybody always thinks that I, after yeah. Halloween, it just sort of shuts down. But then it really, all the work starts kicking in for next year. All the getting
oh,
different
gotcha.
Things planning, and I'm writing another movie, and I've got the reality show, and I'm doing a video
good
game.
Good God,
an Xbox
woman.
Video game.
Slow down.
So.
Oh, yeah, really? A video
really
game?
Really gears up, yeah,
awesome.
For Xbox.
Awesome. And then are you the type of person that goes out and secures these adventures yourself, or do you have someone in charge of the Elvira Enterprise?
I do it. Mm-hmm. I have okay. people who do it, like licensing, merchandising people, and a manager, and a
right.
business manager.
Wow,
blah, blah, blah,
good.
All those other people I support besides my husband.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
God, do you, and you know what? You are, I will say to the listeners, you are still absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
But my fiance, she's only, I don't I'm not sure. I think she's in her teens, but she already, because she, you know, she wants to be a model and an actress, and she's just taking off. She's gotten for her first movie
right.
and a couple, you know, she's going to be on a fitness magazine
right.
and some other
wow.
things soon.
Me
but
too.
She's already worried, you know, about, you know, as a female, though, we only have a certain amount of time.
That's
you
right.
you guys can just go and go and go with your career. But so does that ever... play into your mind?
That comes up more frequently, and so that's why I'm thinking of getting into animation. Mm. I'm thinking of becoming animated.
Really? So
idea.
You would be a cartoon?
She may want to consider being a cartoon.
Okay.
Because cartoons, sure. you know, never get old.
That's no, they
so,
don't.
So I'm sort of, and that's also part of the reality show, mm-hmm. looking for other Elviras that go around in malls and people sit on their
okay.
lap and tell them what they want for Halloween, stuff
wow.
like that.
Okay.
So you diversify when mm-hmm. you get older.
Let's go to Mikey in Jersey. Mikey, how are you?
Hey, what's up, dog guys?
What?
Come on!
Come on! Boo. Thank you.
Hey, Elvira.
Yes, I'm missing something here. Uh-huh. Yes?
I'll knock the dust off of that any day. You don't worry about it. You're never getting old.
Oh, thank you.
I
love you.
That is so classy. Mm-hmm.
The dust off.
Oh, I do.
The Wendy?
I do. No, I'll knock
Come
the dust
on.
Off. He's just being crude. But
no, I know, but I just didn't hear the whole...
I think he meant something. I'll knock.
No, I know. I know.
Well, the end part sounded good anyway, so I don't care.
Yeah, yeah.
Get in line, man. Let's go to Will in Brooklyn.
Dog house.
What?
Let me ask you, Elvira. Have you ever gotten busy in that costume?
Of course.
Ever gotten busy? What does he mean by that? I wonder. I think I know what you mean.
He's pulled over on the side of the road in his
way
pants.
Way too uncomfortable. I gotta tell you. I mean, you know. Over all those years, my husband, I guess that's why we ended up divorcing, because it was
goes
like,
away.
Don't screw up the wig. God, my hair, my makeup.
Right.
So, kind of one of those.
Yeah,
was he ever jealous of all the attention that you would get? Would that create a problem?
No. Well, probably jealous that he wasn't getting it.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Like,
you?
Attention.
Were you more career-oriented? Or
yeah.
What's the loser do? I mean, the,
he doesn't have to work. That's
oh,
hard.
In
doesn't
there.
Have
that's,
to work.
That's
I know what that's
not
about.
Right.
Yeah.
I could put him on my list.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody needs to be shot behind the shed.
Yeah.
Your husband. Definitely.
All right. Let's do this really quick. And then, or before we do, for the people just tuning in, we
yes.
have Elvira.
Mm-hmm.
The there's no.
That's right.
Awesome.
Be out there. I hope not freezing my
And
body.
If you are one of those pet owners that wants to talk with other pet owners, then go to
mypetscene.com. Pet scene.
All right.
That was good, you guys.
Yeah, that's what we've done.
I'll go last this time. I usually win, so try not to ruin my record here.
Because you're paying the people off here.
What are you doing now?
We're going to do this contest really quick.
Oh.
These are all actual articles.
Right.
And then you have to pick the one that really should. Do you believe in capital punishment?
No.
Well, we do.
No, I don't. No, I don't.
Actually, I don't really either, but these people, if I did believe in it.
Right. For ratings, he'll believe in it.
Okay.
Yes, absolutely. 100%.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you got to do it that way. I'll go first here.
Okay.
This 44-year-old man in Saginaw, Michigan, is in jail on charges of bestiality after he was seen engaged in acts with a dead dog.
Oh, God,
tell him not to go to my
This guy was arrested after police searched the area he was in. The entire incident was in...
Can I get a dog scream?
Yeah.
No.
Just do it, dummy.
The entire incident was within view of a nearby daycare center.
Oh.
Cops said a woman from the daycare center called animal control because there was a dead dog near the property. But before the officers could arrive, he showed up and began engaging an axe with the dog.
Come on.
Yes. Troopers searched the area, found the man hiding in the attic of a nearby house. He is in jail now. Could be in prison for up to 15 years.
Let's hope.
He should.
These are the people that should not go to my pet scene.
No! Or maybe they should.
No, he's an animal lover.
He's a lover.
Yes,
he's an animal lover.
He still loved them even after they were dead.
Took it to the extreme.
I love them alive or dead. I don't care. That's my style.
That's it.
Doggy. Here we go with Lou.
A Vermont high school student's walking down a street one day. He finds a...
It sounds like it's going to be a joke.
Yeah.
Vermont. And it kind of is.
A rabbi.
He's walking down the street one day. He finds a blood-encrusted used syringe on the sidewalk. So what does he do? He picks it up.
Oh!
During the course of the next 2 days, he proceeds to stab 8 students with it.
Oh, no!
Right. All these students now have to be vaccinated for Hep B, Hep C, HIV. There's a very good chance that they may have contracted something.
Oh, no.
They don't know what the student did with the needle.
You
he said he threw
bastard.
It away. But this guy, come on. What kind of future does this kid have? We're talking the next Ted Bundy. Put him out of his misery. Come on.
Okay. I still like the bestiality one because it's mine.
This should be an easy one for me once again. I'm sure I'll win.
Okay.
It's a no-boner. Brainer.
Whoa! Yeah. Mama, keep it going, baby.
She knows a lot about you. Did you get that Cialis yet, though?
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Okay.
I haven't seen Alice in years.
That's why.
Okay.
In Alabama, violent attack. A teenager has been charged with, I don't even know if, I mean, the show has been a little raunchy already today. I don't even know if I can say this.
Wow, it's pretty bad then.
I'll let you read it.
Okay.
Look what this kid did.
Can I say that?
Yeah. This high school kid raped his own mother.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Man.
What? Oh, well. Albertville police say Gary Helms, Jr., 19, charged with first-degree rape. There was a dispute with he and his brother. It started over another girl, and because mom took the other brother's side, he acted out revenge on the girl.
Wow.
They're investigating what he did to the other girl, and he also raped his mom.
Classy. Classy.
So, there's your nomination.
Yeah. I still like
which one? If you had to.
Only one is true, and the others are not.
No. These are all true, but which one do you say should be taken behind the shed and shot in the head?
Necrobestiality in front of a daycare center? Come on.
I mean, your own mom? Come on, Elvira.
She had the HIV to 8 students. So what?
I
know how much you love pets, so think about it. Rover down there. Yeah.
Think about it.
Go with Elvis. He loves you.
Mother.
Okay, wait.
I'd go with the dog.
It's out only.
MyPetScene.com. MyPetScene.com.
I'm actually going to go with the kid who stuck the kid.
You?
God.
Lou gets a win.
Finally.
I mean, that might be the most devastating. That might have the worst consequences. The dog is dead already.
Hey, watch it.
The mother what?
Well,
mother wanted it. I heard you.
Horrible. I'd have to meet the family first.
Right.
They probably live in trailers in Florida.
Yes, right. So this is going to happen anyway.
Is,
right.
The kids could all get God knows what.
That's
hepatitis.
Right.
Yeah. AIDS.
That's true.
That's true.
Young kids. That has the farthest reaching consequences.
Damn. Elvira.
Yes.
Like the caller said, very gorgeous, very beautiful, very entertaining.
Very much so.
A great interview. You are awesome. Congratulations on all of your success. Everyone, let's continue to support her. Go to Elvira.com. Mm-hmm. There's many of the things that she was talking about, videos and costumes.
All kinds of stuff.
And you got the, Elvira dildo on there?
I don't have that
with
yet.
The wig?
But believe me, I've merchandised just about everything else.
Uh-huh. Really?
You being divorced now. So,
but next time, have this show later, because as the day wears on, I look better.
You look
really good tonight.
You look
beautiful right now.
Is there a party afterwards that you're inviting me to?
I don't know. We'll see.
Okay. I'm going to leave you my number.
You're there.
Okay.
It has been
all right, good.
I mean, painfully for me, obvious, to watch this guy try to hit on you and for you to shoot him down. I just so we make this very clear right
what,
now.
What?
Because I know what he's going to do.
What?
When you leave, he's going to be like, did you see that? She was all over me. Oh. So let's make it clear now.
Yeah, that she was.
All of these advances that he's putting forth towards you.
I'm just being myself, and she's hot, and she wants me. That's cool.
Let me finish the question.
I'm like, come
with
on.
All of these advances, are you receptive to him at all? I mean, is it? Are you attracted to him? Are you feel? Are you feeling the vibe from him?
Dimples.
He's a little older than I usually.
Oh! You are so dead. Don't go to mypetscene.com. Don't go to Elvira.com. In fact, throw stuff at her at the parade.
I'm just kidding. Just a year or two.
So okay, yeah, okay, right.
Just,
I know you are.
Borderline.
So what are you gonna say when she walks out?
Oh, all over me.